Hello, my Squirrel Tribe 2.0. How is everybody doing? It is Monday, my dudes. Listen, just wanted to come here today with just a short little video. Let me read this to you. I'm going to show you a picture. Then we're going to have a little discussion. And then I want your comments after the video in the comment section below. Okay, so listen to this. A lot of you may have already seen this or heard about this, but I wanted to bring it to the attention again if you already knew about it, and bring it to new attention if you did not know about this. So listen, at the World Championship in Budapest in June, the United States of America's Anita Alvarez sank to the bottom of the pool. This is in the synchronized swimming, I believe it was. Looking across the deck, then noticing she was under for way too long, her coach, Andrea Fuentes, immediately dove in after her, fully clothed, pulling her to safety. Anita was unconscious and didn't have the capacity to kick, to paddle, or help herself in any way whatsoever. If Andrea would not have noticed, Anita would have drowned. Basic, plain and simple, right? But she knew Anita. Andrea knew Anita. She looked for her, quickly noticed that she was under too long, then dove in without thinking twice. This has resonated with me. When you are under too long, who are the people that will look for you, notice, and dive in to pull you to the surface when you lose your strength to swim? Who are the people that would do that for you? And can someone count on you to be that person that would go looking and notice when they are under too long, diving in to support them when they all are out of, when they are out of all, y'all, I can't remember my own writing. Diving in to support them when they are all out of fight and fuel to swim in these turbulent waters we call life. Now here's the picture. I'm going to show you the picture. And I can guarantee you guys have seen this. Sorry, my cup is in the way. Move cup. I can guarantee you guys have seen this somewhere on the internet in the last few months, because this was a huge deal. Now, the reason I'm bringing this to you, because I'm just kind of curious. What's interesting here is when it says here, when you are under too long, who are the people that will look for you, that will notice and dive in to pull you to the surface when you lose your strength to swim? Can someone count on you to be that person that would go looking and notice when they are under too long, diving in to support them when they're all out of fight and fuel to swim in these turbulent waters we call life? And y'all, we already know this isn't about swimming. It was for the moment of that story. But basically, it's, do you pay attention to the people around you, your friends, your family, your coworkers, your neighbors? Do you notice when someone is having a quiet moment, when they seem to be off, when they look like they might need a extra helping hand, a shoulder to lean on, an ear even, or just a friendly smile or whatever else? Are you willing to jump into those situations to be that person to help a stranger, a neighbor, a family member, a friend, whatever else? Are you somebody that people can depend on to get out of your own mind and unfocus on yourself for a moment to focus on somebody else? I know you guys are. I know my Squirrel Tribe is, because you guys have always been there for me and I appreciate you immensely. I notice a lot of times when I'm out and about that people seem to be kind of in their own world a lot of the time, not paying attention to what's going on around them, not noticing if somebody's struggling with something, not noticing if somebody looks like they've been crying or are crying, or if there's just not like a spark in somebody's eye, somebody's face when you're talking to them. And I just think it's important that we as people look, open your eyes and look around. And I know we're all selfish to an extent. We want to make sure that we're happy, we're good, which is, there's nothing wrong with that. You have to be happy in your life before you can help anybody else be happy in theirs. I fully believe that. But I do think that a lot of times we also need to open our eyes and look at everybody around us and see what we can do to help. If we were more willing as a people to share a kind word, share a smile, share a hug with a stranger, share just a helpful word or whatever else, I think we'd be in a much better situation just like as a humanity, than we are now, because a lot of people are too focused on themselves and not worried about other people. And I think we should all worry about the people around us. Everybody wants to have somebody that they can turn to. Everybody wants to have somebody that will say, hey, how are you doing? And legitimately mean it. Not that little BS small talk. Oh, how's your day? Good? Cool. And then they don't even wait for your response. They don't really listen to it. They don't really hear what you have to say. Too many times people go, how are you doing? And out of just, I would say, habit, you go, fine, even if you're not. Because nobody actually wants to hear if you're not fine, right? That's how we feel. So I think it'd be great if every once in a while you say, hey, how are you doing today? And somebody says, fine. And you stop, you pause and say, are you really? Is there anything you would like to talk about? Do you need an ear? Do you need a shoulder? I am here. just those little words could have a massive impact on just somebody's, not even just their day, but maybe their entire life. So that's just a random Monday morning thought that I wanted to bring out to you guys, because I've seen people lately who seem to be a little more down than normal. And I don't know if it's, you know, our economy. I don't know if it's family things. I don't know half these people that I see and notice that their shoulders are a little slumped, or they're looking down, not looking up, or their face doesn't seem to, their eyes don't seem to smile when their face smiles, or something like that. So I just think that as a people, it would be really nice if we could just try to lift other people up, say positive, helpful things to people. You see a stranger, like yesterday I was walking to the apartment, and this lady was walking past me, and all I said was, "Man, I love your outfit." That's all it is. And you get that immediate smile. Like, it's so easy to say one nice thing to somebody and watch it change their face, their body posture, absolutely everything about them. And it takes nothing from you. In fact, it adds to you, because then you feel good about what you've done to make somebody else feel good. So I implore everybody to go do something today that makes somebody else feel good, which in turn makes you feel good. It's a two for one, y'all. It's a two for one. Who doesn't like a two for one? You know what I'm saying? So that is it. Short and sweet to the point, just to say I love you guys. And if anybody needs anything, we're here in the comments. Jump in. We're here for each other. Squirrel Tribe family, right? So I love you all, and I will see you again later. Bye.